welcome to Herstory. Today on the show we have Grace Murray Harper.
Ahoy!
An incredible woman who did a lot of pioneering things with computers that I frankly don't really understand all that much.
Grace Murray Harper reporting for this interview.
Grace, you ever one of those days when you wake up and you say to yourself, is this it? Next question. Now, Grace Harper, you were quite good in school, but you were denied early admission to Vassar because of low Latin scores, to which I say carpe diem e pluribus unum.
How in Latin do you say, I got 40 honorary degrees from places around the United States and the entire globe?
40? Now, I think it's hilarious that they didn't let me in early. While you were bulldozing through academia, a mustachioed man named Adolf Hitler was bulldozing through Europe, effectively starting World War II. At which point, in 1943, you decided to join up with the Navy.
I did join up with the Navy, but because I am female, and at the time, the US military did not fully accept women into its ranks, I had to join up with something called WAVES, which is Women Accepted for Voluntary Emergency Service.
That, however, was my entree to Harvard University, to their computer lab, where I was introduced to Mark One.
Girlfriend, do dish. I'm assuming that this was a boyfriend you had in the lab who probably wooed you on late night walks.
Mark One was not a man, he was a computer.
Grace is very reminiscent of the time that I was catfished.
You've got boys on the brain.
Can you fall in love with a computer? Because I did.
The Mark One series at Harvard was one of the very first large-scale digital computing machines in United States history.
I was one of three people who had ever really laid a hand on it, and I wrote an operating manual for it, and this is what got me really interested in computer programming. My seminal invention, and I feel, by the way, that everyone should have a seminal invention, was something called a compiler. It allows a computer to translate English prompts into computer code that it can then use to execute programs. Very basic stuff that you would learn today in computer science. Okay, but it was revolutionary at the time.
Well, not only were you a real whiz at translating English into computer code, you also translated computer problems into English code by coming up with the term debugging. Get this, there was actually a bug in your computer!
Yes, that's true. We literally had to debug one of our computers because a moth had gotten in it. And we taped the moth into one of our logbooks, so it ended up in the hands of the Smithsonian.
I think I got a little typo in my teleprompter because it says that in 1963 you were awarded the very first Computer Science Man of the Year award from the Data Processing Management Association.
No, that was not a typo. I was awarded a Man of the Year.
Grace?
I was one of few, not only women doing this, but also just people in general working on these things like the computer programming, this very rudimentary type of compiler work, really getting computers to work the way that they do today.
Well, Grace, it is little wonder that your nickname is Amazing Grace, which reminds me of a little song that I once wrote.
Oh, please don't sing.
Oh.
Amazing Grace.
You're really running the scales.
How sweet. Oh. You can join in at any time. The
song is curdling like old milk.
Thank you for letting me have that moment. Okay. By the time you retired from the military in 1986, you are 79 years old, you had been promoted to Rear Admiral, you were the oldest active duty commissioned officer in that branch of the military. At the end of the day, you had a very compelling answer for what your proudest professional accomplishment was.
I believe you're referring to a famous quote of mine in which I say that, yes, the most important thing I've done with my work, aside from the invention of that compiler, is training up younger people. So these kids come to me, you know, and they say, do you think that I can make this work, whatever kind of computer problem it is? And I say, try it. And I keep track of them as I get older, and I stir them up at regular intervals so that they don't forget to take chances.
I can only say namaste forever to you for doing all that you did and inspiring so many herstories out there.
Thank you for having me, and thank you in advance for not seeing.
Amen.